All right, so we got CJ the champ. We ain't watched one of his videos in a grip. Matter of fact, why am I not subscribed? Oh, I'm subscribed on my other channel. Okay, anyway, make sure you like, comment, subscribe to me too. If you can't think of nothing to comment, just put a fire emote or something. And follow me on Twitch, crunk_jeezy with two Y's. From you see it in the background with a K, crunk_jeezy. But let's go ahead and get right into it. See, I watched this anime, by the way, y'all. So I fuck with this anime. I already know I'm gonna like this video. I know this nigga's comedy. This nigga CJ the champ. So this is gonna be a good reaction. I can already tell you.
I'm going to jail.
What the fuck?
Alrighty, ladies.
I swear I didn't restart that. I don't know why I did it. I don't know why I did it that time.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. It is time for another installment of anime's deadliest serial killers.
I'm listening.
And today we dive into the case of the most notorious serial killer in anime history. And that is none other than Kira, aka Light Yagami. And my God, with all the evidence and the amount of victims this man racked up, this case is going to be a beefy one. So let's stop wasting time. So without
let's stop wasting time.
It's time to dive in to the Kira case.
Nigga said five. Okay.
Light Yagami, one of the most diabolical niggas to ever exist. A man with a kill count that ranges in the six figures. Had a whole cult praising this nigga, thinking that he's the Messiah.
I need somebody to help me glorify
God. Oh, I forgot about that.
Stretch out your arms.
Nigga look like a Boondocks character.
And say anyway.
But you have to wonder how the actual did this generic ass background character looking toothpick built ass nigga become one of the most notorious mass murderers in fiction? Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is why we're
just one of them background characters.
We need to know what the hell the weapon was to commit all these homicides. And that, of course, is the Death Note. Now, I'm pretty sure everybody knows how this
the Death Note itself.
If you forgot, here's a quick refresher. The human whose name is written in this note shall die. The note will not take effect unless the right.
Real quick, y'all. I just ordered a Death Note. So some of y'all's names going in there. I'm not saying who, but some of y'all's names going in there.
It's in their mind in when there. Writing his or her name. Therefore, people sharing the same name will not be affected. If the cause of death is written within 40 seconds of writing the person's name, it will happen. And finally, after writing the cause of death,
a heart attack
should be written in the next 6 minutes and 40 seconds.
If not, then by default, you will have a heart attack and die.
Now, with all that explained, we can now move into the first major incident. And that is, of course, the first confirmed 52 victims. Now,
when
he first found the Death Note, when it conveniently dropped right in front of him, he thought to himself, man, this is some bullshit. What is this, a sick joke? Who the hell would believe this? But Light, being a little curious George, decided to take the book. So later on, when Light got home, bro
should have left the book there.
So he ended up thinking in his head, it doesn't hurt to try it out, right? So Light's intrusive thoughts took over.
Y'all remember when this meme was viral? Shoot, you said Light was a demon. He was pretty much, well, he was just petty when he was going after everyone. Nah, real talk. That nigga Ryuk. Right.
Breaking news. A local crackhead is holding 8 children hostage at a daycare.
A local crackhead is crazy.
Let's write this guy's name down. I mean, he's a criminal after all. So 40 seconds later, the news comes back on and says,
breaking news. Children have
breaking
been set
news.
Free and the assailant just f***ed over and died.
Well, this man Light was shook. He was
right.
Like, no.
Right. At that moment, it's just like, I don't know. Hey, that's a hell of a coincidence. That's a hell of a coincidence. Nah, let me try this book one more time. Also, I smell food. Y'all know my mom was here, right? I wonder if she's cooking something. But like, the responsibility in me makes me want to go check real quick just to make sure. I mean, it don't smell like nothing's burning. Whatever.
Coincidence, right?
Whatever.
No fucking way.
All right. But it was anyway, sorry. My fault.
Well, this man Light was shook. He was like, no.
Ain't no fucking way.
No fucking way, right? but it was no coincidence. This local crackhead was.
I would have been like, what the fuck? Bro, what the fuck?
Because he thought it just had to be a random coincidence that bro had a heart attack when he wrote his name down. So later on that.
I don't blame him. I would double check.
He ends up seeing this lady walking, and these bikers come up and start to harass her. So ugly biker bastard right here ends up saying, hey there, pretty lady. How about you come fuck with a real nigga and come in? Spit on that
thing. Man, hot tour. Spit on that thing. Oh, yeah. Right, this shit was fucked up, bro. I'm glad Light killed these niggas.
But Light was in the
game. He killed that one nigga.
The whole thing, like, not on my watch, you 69 gods. So he wrote
you 69.
And made the cause be of accidental death. And the rest was history. Old girl breaks away while ugly bastard tries to track her down.
Watch your jet, bro.
Watch your jet, bro. Damn, see,
just like that light,
but see, that was body, and this man was see, bro. Like, you can't, can you be mad at him for killing that nigga though? Like, I know he was just testing it, but like, he didn't just test it on some innocent civilian. No, let me test it on this nigga that's trying to grape the fruit, YouTube, grape people. Like, come on now,
he was like,
let me get that nigga.
No fucking way.
Oh, shit, my bad.
I just summoned trouble. That means I must be a fucking god.
And I must be a point, god.
Light's god.
Hell nah, nigga.
Was born. This man went back to the crib, locked the door, looking like he about to beat that thing, and said, "I'm about to cleanse this world of its garbage." So this man looked up a list of.
Nigga said, "I can kill people. I'm finna kill people, nigga."
It looked like he had an essay due the next day, and he just started racking up bodies.
So many people. He already had these niggas in mind. Like, these are niggas that he already was going. Like, he was at least thinking about killing if he could. Like, ain't no way, bruh. How do you know the name?
And this man went through the whole night just writing down names until two whole pages were full. And look at this man breathing hard as hell, looking like he just ran a 5K. And just off of that,
nigga was just right for his life. Shit.
Criminals. Now here's the wild part. That was just criminals that died of heart attacks. Because when Interpol got this information, they was like, there could be some people that were unaccounted for. So that death toll could have easily been over 100.
Real talk.
All of his first victims, the name Kira started spreading like wildfire because Light was constantly dropping off niggas. Every single day, he was killing multiple criminals, and people all around the world were supporting this man. They had Reddit threads and Discord servers just glazing this nigga, and this just amped up his god complex even more. Bro, just looking at
shit.
This guy, yeah, that's right. Glaze me, nigga. Polish this Willy. And of course, now he got this A1 instigating Shinigami Ryuk attached to his hip the whole time now.
Nah, for real. This nigga, bro. I mean, when you understand where Ryuk is coming from, you feel me? It's not, eh. It's like, what, you know, he don't got nothing better to do. But still, this nigga was definitely instigating. He just, look at him in the back eating apples and shit. Niggas just like be like, shit, should I kill this one nigga that's been, I don't know, causing havoc in the local Starbucks? I don't know, man. Maybe you should try. I mean, I heard him talking about you the other day too. Like, no, you didn't, nigga.
Like, hip the whole time now. But even though Light was killing only criminals, at the end of the day, it was still murder. And this is when this man fell for the.
Yeah, it was still murder, but. He's killing bad people, though.
At the end
he's
of
killing
the day,
bad people. You say he fumbled the bag extremely early with that, with, oh, yeah. No, I feel you, Galactic. Literally, if he didn't go crazy at the beginning, killing niggas so much, like, bro, he could have beat L. L could have never found out. And then, because, like, bro, honestly, in my opinion, the biggest L was at the beginning where L himself found out that Light Yagami, aka Kira, was in Japan. And I'm just like, damn, nigga, it could have been anybody in the world. But you made it easy for him, and now he know you in Japan, bro. Because, like, he's about to explain it. CJ finna explain it, but just damn. That was, like, the main thing for me. I was just like, bro. Like, it was so easy to not fall for that. But, I mean, I can understand, though. You got carried away. You didn't think about it, but still.
Killing only criminals. At the end of the day, it was still murder. And this is when
it was still murder. It was still murder.
Trap. Now, this is the moment where you just think to yourself, what if Light never made this crucial mistake? And that mistake was killing Lynda L. Taylor.
No, thank you. That's basically what I was saying. Like, what if he never made this one mistake, bro? Like, nigga could have actually, bro. nigga could have took over the world and everything. It was this one mistake that got him, though. It had to be.
Crucial mistake. And that mistake was killing Lynda L. Taylor on live TV. So a worldwide public service announcement comes on TV. And this man announces himself as L. But obviously, this ain't L. But Light didn't know. So Lynda L. Taylor starts speaking and saying,
"Good afternoon, world. My name is Lynda L. Taylor. Kira, if you're watching this, we have a message for you. You are evil, and you are just a mindless serial killer. And I'm gonna bring your punk ass to justice."
So while Light is watching this, here come this instigating ass nigga. "Light, I'm not gonna lie, that nigga pressing your shit right now. So what the fuck you gonna do about it, huh?"
Oh God, like, this is not verbatim what he said at all. But that's basically what he was saying. This nigga instigating, bro.
"That nigga pressing your shit right now. So what the fuck you gonna do about it, huh?
Fuck you gonna do about it?"
Light, his ego is challenged. "You think I'm fucking evil? Quit all that fucking yapping, nigga. I am God, and you can suck my divine dick 6 feet under." So Light got to work quick. He wrote bro's name down in a heartbeat. And after he finished, he was like, "Yeah, that's right. I'll show the world what happens if you defy me." So 40 seconds later, and Lynda L. Taylor has a heart attack, croaks over, and dies. And here go Light thinking he got it in the bag.
"What's yeah.
Wrong, huh? Get the fuck up, huh? Pussy, you was talking to that shit."
I'm fucking weak. Why they play the Discord sound like him joining a Discord party or something? Oh my God.
"You was talking to that shit.
What's good, fuck nigga?
Huh?
What's good, fuck nigga? What up, gay?
Believe it. You was one dumbass nigga. You really think I get my introverted ass on TV and fucking press you like this? You one stupid ass nigga. And now I know all your shit. The dude you just killed? Yeah, he was due for execution today anyway, so he could go fuck off. Also, this is not a worldwide broadcast. We only broadcasting this in the Kanto region of Japan."
Hey, see? That was that right there, bro. See, now they know you in Japan. Like, see? That's what I was saying. And that, bro, the process of elimination was drastic right there. Because it could have been any state, any country. But nah, just Japan's little small ass, like, bro, they gonna find you eventually. Shit, had L believed that he was around the whole world, like, bro, L would have never caught him, bro. I don't care what nobody say. He would have never caught him. At least in time. I'm not saying he was smart enough to do it, but he wouldn't have caught him in time. Nope. You said he was supposed to be at the top of his class. Right. Ryuk only instigated all this because he was bored in the Shinigami realm. Real talk. Yeah, he was killing criminals, but he was going after anyone who crossed him. Yeah, he was doing too much at that point. Like, hey, nigga, you can't just kill anybody that you disagree with. Come on now. Say, yep, L was ordered to some unethical tactics as well. But see, I understand Galactic, but it wasn't that unethical because that nigga was scheduled, the nigga L. Lynn Taylor, he was scheduled for execution that very day. You feel me? Come on now. He was ready to die anyway. Unless you're talking about something else. Because if you're talking about that part, I don't feel like it was that bad. If he was supposed to die that day anyway, whatever, you know? I mean, it don't mean it's not fucked up a little bit, but. And he was gonna die anyway. You feel me? That's just how I feel, but yeah. But alright, my fault. Side ran over. Right, do it. But you can't kill him.
Or is it that you need a name and a face?
Fuck. Yup, got your ass. See?
He got your ass.
Right, baby, that's what I'm saying. Ryu.
Kira, know this. Shit. Oh, my mama, I'm coming for your bitch ass, and I'm gonna put your nigga ass in a slammer.
So after this man L played Light like a fool and pressed the living hell out of him, the investigation on...
What the fuck was this nigga Light even... L, where the fuck was he even chilling at, bro? I swear that nigga was in the hyperbolic time chamber, and he brought a battery and a laptop with him. Nigga, where are you?
Kira, when L
where are you at? Light, and I'm gonna put your... This nigga in the hyperbolic time chamber. Where is he at? See?
this man L played light like a fool and pressed the living hell out of him, the investigation on Carol went into full effect.
Of the Cure task force resigned because of that.
Set of evidence and next set of victims. Shit. And our first key victim is Ray Pinberg. Now, Ray Pinberg was a FBI agent.
I see what you're saying, Galactic.
So big that this man L ended up getting help from the FBI to come solve this case. Because that's how horrendous this shit got. Because Light was murdering like 23 niggas a day at this point. He was dropping at least one body an hour.
And just he was killing niggas left and right,
so
bro.
L suspected that whoever Kira was had to have ties to the police. Because how the hell would this person be getting all this information on these criminals? And what do you know? Light's dad is the police chief. So L basically made every single person that had ties to the police be kept under surveillance by the FBI. And Ray Pimber's job was to survey Light. And obviously Light didn't need this type of heat. So Light decided to put this man.
That nigga's like me though with that part. Cause like, nah, nigga watching me. What's up then? Hold on.
So Light decided.
What's up then, nigga?
This man in a coffin. So Light.
Right, he's not gonna see me coming.
And that was the bus jacking incident.
I'm not saying it's right though, y'all. I'm not saying it's right. You said the UK probably.
So for
not
this,
GB, what?
Light needed a guinea pig. So he found another local crackhead on the most wanted
list. A local crackhead.
Saruda. I'm not gonna lie, I just butchered that man's name. So the second part of his plan, he needed a shorty. So this man dialed up one of his shorties on his roster and called her and said,
"Hello.
I'm over here stroking my dick. I got lotion on my dick right now. I'm just stroking my shit. I'm horny as fuck, man. I'm a freak, man. Like, for real."
"You's a freaky ass nigga."
So the next day,
she was a freaky ass nigga.
Girl to go on their date to Disneyland. And of course, Ray Pinberg is right behind them, following them, all according to Light's plan. So they end up getting on the bus, and Ray Pinberg sits right behind them. So about a good 15 minutes
right
later, they stop at the next bus stop, and the local crackhead gets on the bus. And this man wasted no time. He cocked back the gun and said, "All right, everybody, sit the fuck down and do your best Rosa Parks impersonation. I'm gonna blow this nigga brains out. But sir, please, I ain't playing with you, nigga."
Rosa Parks impersonation. Said,
"Bring out all the cash you made today, and make sure the nigga that's bringing out got on a Minnie Mouse costume."
"Sir, we're able to comply with your demands, but why the Minnie Mouse costume?"
"So I can get that off, nigga. The fuck."
What?
So while this lunatic is out of his mind and going wild, this man Ray Pinberg leans over and says, "All right, y'all, like he said, stay calm and do your best Rosa Parks impersonation. My name is Ray Pinberg, FBI."
Rosa
so
Parks
this
impersonation.
Man Light looked at this man's ID.
See, set him up perfectly. Ray Pinberg. Your ass going into death note now, nigga. Going into death note now.
All according to plan. So Light digs in his pocket and drops a piece of paper on the floor. So the crackhead's like, "The fuck you moving for, you little shit? You want me to blow your brains out, nigga?" But Light meant to drop that paper.
But it's a piece of the death note. It's a piece of the death note.
Piece of the death note. So old boy turns around and starts tweaking. Cause he ends up seeing Ryuk behind him. So bro just starts emptying the mag, trying to shoot this man Ryuk, but obviously it ain't working. So bro ran up to the bus driver and said, "Lord, get me off this bus." So the bus driver stops. Bro runs out into the street, and Cartoon comes flying down the street and splatters this nigga's guts like the Nickelodeon logo.
Like the Nickelodeon logo was crazy.
Of course,
real quick, y'all.
Light is sitting on this bus.
Real quick, I'm about to turn the volume up a little bit because I actually want it to be up higher. Sorry, y'all.
And of course, Light is sitting on this bus with no emotion, looks at his watch, and said, 11:45 on the dot.
On the
right
dot.
On schedule.
Right on
Light
schedule.
Staged this entire bus jacking.
Yup.
Using the death note, he made this man board the bus, attempt to hijack it, then jump out and get hit by a car due to accidental death. And then at the end of this,
crazy.
Remember thinks nothing suspicious of this man. Cause he thought, he couldn't be Kira. Cause he would have just offed him when he got on the bus. So now this man does not suspect Light, and Light has his name. So after Light boomed the second local crackhead, it was time to move into phase three of his plan. So about a week later, at a subway station, he ends up seeing Ray Pinberg walking. So Light puts on his hood looking like he about to hit a lick. So he gets behind him and says, "Ray Pinberg,
about to hit another lick.
Don't move a fucking muscle or I'll drop your ass right here." So Light tells this man that he's Kira. And to prove it, he said, "Look over there. You see that nigga with them glasses on? I'ma drop that nigga right now." and bro right here starts having a heart attack and dies. Bro straight up off this man in the public eye. And then Light told him,
don't worry, you shouldn't feel bad for him. He was a registered sex offender and a PDF file. Caught him talking to three little boys the other day.
So, right, it's like, you feel me? Don't feel that bad for him. But like, I'm not saying Light deserves to be the judge and jury and shit. I'm just saying, like, come on, man.
Light gets him
like, you gonna be upset about that? Like, come
on. Later on, when he boards the train, Light tells him to open the envelope. And he sees all these papers. So Light says in his ear,
I want you to write your boss's name in every single FBI agent that came here in Japan. Do what I'ma drop your ass and your bitch right the fuck now.
So Ray Pember writes down all the names. So after this, Light told him, wait 30 minutes and then get off the train. So 30 minutes pass. Ray Pember gets off the train and it happens.
That's
right
it.
Before the lights went out, this man looked up and saw who Kira was the whole time and thought before he died,
you've got to be fucking kidding me.
So after the lights went out for Ray Pember, so did the rest of the FBI's. Because the sheet that Ray Pember wrote those names on were Death Note sheets. So the other 11 agents that were in Japan and his boss shortly died right after Ray. And just like that, Light Yagami did the unthinkable. This man bitched the FBI. Because the director of the FBI calls L and tells him,
Mr. L, I'm sorry, but
America's going to have to pull out of this one. This shit's getting out of hand. Now, it seems that Light is ready to make his victory lap, but there was one problem. There was a loose end, and that loose end was Ray Pember's fiance, a former FBI agent.
Ooh.
So she did some snooping around and quickly figured out whoever Kira was had to be on that bus. Also, she ended up figuring out that he can kill in other ways besides a heart attack. So a couple days later, she goes to the police station because she's basically figured out this entire thing. All she needs to know was who was on the bus. So when she goes to the police station and asks to speak to Light's dad, who is over the case, just by coincidence, Light walks in and overhears her talking about it. So Light was like,
who the hell is this bitch?
So he walks up to her and tells her, hi, excuse me.
Had he never heard her over talking it though, or talking about it, I mean, see? I don't know. You say he fumbled a Ray Pember too. He was literally going to conclude his investigation after the bus jacket incident. Yeah, see? See? The part with Ray's wife is what made me go, this dude is a demon. Yeah. Yeah,
Light,
I already know.
Pleasure to meet
you. I already know,
you see, my dad is the chief of the police force, so I can help you out real quick. You know what I'm saying? So they end up walking outside, and they start chatting it up. So the first thing Light asks is, Miss Beautiful Miss, can I have your name? So she says, my name's Shoko Maki. So Light already has the name. So now his plan was to just talk her up, figure out what she knows, and if she knew too much, he was gonna off her. So kept on talking, and she just kept on yapping. But everything she said was right. And the real stinger was, she said that,
So my fiance said that he showed somebody his ID, and he wasn't supposed to. So whoever he showed his ID to, that's most definitely Kira.
So Light was like, shit!
She knows way too much.
She knows way too fucking much.
Because if they pull up them bus cameras, Light's cooked. So here go this sinister ass nigga. So bro starts asking her questions, but in reality, he's writing down her name. So Light thinks he's got her.
But a couple of more seconds pass, and she's still alive.
Nani?
So Light ends up figuring out, because Ryuk's ass was laughing at him the whole time, that she used the alias. So
testing,
that was not
testing,
her real name.
Testing.
So Light is starting to shake. It is do or die right now. Because if she gets back to the police station, he's done. So
I'm listening, y'all. Why? If she gets back to the police station, it's a wrap.
Well, you see, ma'am, it's going to be actually impossible for you to go back to the police station because they're very busy right now. But it's okay though, because I'm on the Kira task force. Oh my gosh, really?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, really? You're on the Kira task force? You're on the Kira task force? What?
And told her, you know what, ma'am, you are really smart. You should join the task force with us. All you gotta do is show me your ID so I can check your credentials. So obviously, she jumped at the idea because she wants to bring her fiance's killer to justice.
So she whips out her ID and it's over. Light saw her real name, wrote it down, and made the cause be of unaliving herself. So right before tragedy was about to strike, she asked this man,
why do you keep on looking at your watch?
Oh,
because I'm Kira. Duh, stupid bitch.
and it was okay. Walking away, and she's going to unalive herself in GTA. And while she's walking away, this
damn,
is
just
talking and saying, "Oh, ma'am, what's wrong? You still need to use my phone, right? I thought we were gonna catch Kira." And what makes this even more tragic, they never found her body. We don't know what the hell happened to her. All we know is that she unalived herself. And with that, the bus jacking incident comes to a close.
Dang, now see, I can't get with you on that one. Like, I can't get with you on that one. I ain't gonna hold you. That one was a lot. See?
Close.
I understand, though. It's like you can't get caught, because if you get caught, then you can't keep doing the things you was, you know, no, but like.
That she unalived. Or tragic. They never found her body. We don't know what.
Never found her. You said this was heartbreaking. She unalived herself. Shit. That, she was smart, but not smart enough. Comes to a close. Yo.
Alrighty, chop chop, moving on, we got more people dying. Flip the board for our next set of evidence. Now, obviously, we know Light's biggest opposition is L. One of the smartest characters in fiction, this nigga's anime Sherlock Holmes. And this man was on Light's ass 24-7, cause he right. had a hunch that Light was Kira. I mean, he literally walked up to Bro and said, "Hey man, my name's L, and I think there's a 5% chance that you're Kira."
What?
I'm not sure all the way, but there's like a 5% chance, bruh. He had this man join the Kira Task Force.
There's like a 5% chance, bruh.
He even had cameras set up in his room watching him 24-7. So you know damn well that he was watching him yanking his shit.
Oh, nah.
And don't be acting like I'm reaching. You think Light was cracking Misa? Fuck no, he hated this bitch. Speaking of that, let me go ahead and introduce the accomplice. The second Kira, Misa. Absolute brain dead. This girl suffers from brain rot. And she's just deeply in love with this nigga. And the reason why is because her parents were murdered. And lo and behold, guess who brought
I mean, that'll fuck anybody up.
The murderer. Yeah, off that nigga. And how she got a death note is even crazier. One night she was walking home and she got approached by some crazy ass.
Oh yeah, the person that killed her parents got killed by Kira, I think. And that's why she's like, "Oh, I love Kira, aka Light Yagami." But you know what I'm saying? Like,
as stalker nigga. And he was ready to kill her. So a Shinigami named Jealous, that was weirdly in love with her, decided to save her life and kill the stalker at the cost of his life. So Rim decided,
I might as well give her the death note. He would have wanted it this way.
And Tada,
he would have wanted it this way.
Became the second Kira. So Light decided to use her because she had the Shinigami eyes, and
she had that Sharingan's
name just by looking at them. But at the cost of a halving your lifespan, though. But Light knew he needed her to dep in his bag so he could kill people 10 times easier. So he made her pose as his girlfriend. So time passes, and one day, L ends up capturing Misa, suspecting her of being the second Kira, because they raided her apartment and just found a bunch of shit. So she got put in confinement. So Light said, "Fuck it, it's time to activate my master plan." So to make sure Misa-
Is that fucking Dr. Eggman?
It's time to activate my master.
That's from Sonic Adventure, ain't it?
Their plan. So to make sure Misa did not confess, he had Rim make her relinquish ownership of the Death Note so it would wipe all of her memories of it. Then had Rim and Ryuk swap notebooks. And in the notebook, he wrote down 2 BS rules that basically said, if the person that is using the notebook hasn't wrote down a name in 13 days, they die. And if you destroy the notebook, all the humans that have used it will die. So he told Rim, go give this notebook to a greedy, power-hungry bastard and let them become Kira, while I give myself up to L, relinquish ownership of the Death Note, and go into solitary confinement for a total of 50 days.
Oh,
and that's what Light did. Because on day 7 of his confinement, Light gave up his ownership of the Death Note and lost all of his memories of it to take all suspicion off of him. And on day 15, the murder started back up again. And the person murdering these people was Mr. Kiyosuke Higuchi of the Yotsuba Group. So him and this group decided to kill other businessmen to further the growth of their company. These niggas was Disney just building a bigger monopoly. But their downfall was they had some rats. And that was these two right here. Because they basically sold out and was talking to L the whole time. So over time after Misa was released from confinement, and L and Light, the two smartest niggas on the earth working on the case simultaneously, ended up figuring out that it was Higuchi. So one night they ended up banning him out with a fake broadcast
podcast saying that they're about to reveal who Kira is. So later on, while this man is speeding down the road, he ends up getting stopped by a cop. So the cop do his thing. He like, license and registration, please. So Higuchi's like, all right. But this man was not reaching for a license. He was reaching for the death note. And he made the Shinigami eye deal so he could see the officer's name. So he wrote bro's name down, but then just hit the gas and took off. So this man starts a whole high-speed chase running from this cop. And about 5 seconds later, the cop ends up having a heart attack and crashes into the back of a truck. Another victim by truck coon. Damn, this nigga's on a tear. So that man said, all units, arrest this nigga. And I kid you not, this shit went from Death Note to Tokyo Drift. So this man
to Tokyo Drift.
Chasing him, L Light and Walter in the chopper. He was not playing games. They said, this shit ends tonight. So while this man Higuchi is speeding on the road, this man runs into a police blockade. So he ends up getting cornered and he is trapped. So he tries to drive the other way, but FaZe Watari is up here on the helicopter and says, not on my watch, fuckboy. And shoots his tire out,
makes
him spin out, and he crashes into the wall. And it was over for Higuchi. They surrounded that man. So they cuff him, pin him down, and they start interrogating him. Now here's where this master manipulator plan comes full circle.
Ooh.
So while they're interrogating him, Higuchi tells him that there is a notebook that allows him to do all of his killings. So Light Dad goes in and searches the car, and he finds the death note. So when he touches
because when he touches it,
and starts looking,
he gets his memory back
and freaks the fuck out. So then the other detective comes over.
Oh wait, this ain't Light though. I'm tripping. Okay.
Are you alright?
My fault. Hold up.
Death note. So when he touches it and starts looking through it, he ends up seeing and freaks the fuck out. So then the other detective comes over and he says, "Chief, are you alright? The fuck you screaming for?"
Oh shit!
So that man
the fuck you screaming for?
The notebook over to the helicopter. So L gets the notebook and just starts staring into nothingness, just going into a deep thought. But he ended up realizing there has to be more than one notebook because there were two Kiras. And while that was happening, Light was like, let me see it. And Light grabbed the notebook.
Yeah, then when he grabs it,
tweak it. Bro, like he entered the avatar state. Every single memory came back into this man's head. So L was like, bro, are you good? And Light was like, oh yeah, I'm perfectly fine. It swaps over.
Hey, bro, you good? Oh, yeah. I am perfectly okay.
Memory came back into this man's head. So
nigga in the avatar state.
Bro, are you good? And Light was like, oh, yeah, I'm perfectly fine. It swaps over to his face, and it's over. This nigga just thinking, yes, I've won. All according to plan. So this man pulls out a piece of paper.
All according to plan.
Plugs himself and makes him bleed and writes down Higuchi's name with his blood. And 40 seconds later, while they're taking him back to the car to arrest him, Higuchi has a heart attack, falls to his knees, and dies. And look at this man's face, bro. It is all over. It was just about to go from here. So they get back to headquarters.
I know when I watched that part of the anime, bro, I was just like, bro. Because like, I knew what his plan was all along. You knew what his plan was the whole time. But
start looking over
when it all came full circle, that shit.
The Death Note. And they find those fake back to headquarters. And they start looking over the Death Note. And they find those fake bogus rules that Light made. And that fake 13 days rule basically cleared him and Misa's name. So they were off the hook. So this is when Light's mass manipulation went overboard. He made Misa go find the other Death Note, gain all of her memories back, then left a note saying, yeah, you remember that guy L? Find his real name and kill him. So she makes the Shinigami ideal again, cutting her lifespan in half again. And
you can do that?
Start killing people again.
Well, what's the point of doing that though? Like, I mean, you already can see everybody's name, so what happens? Like, you can just see them clearer? I mean, the fuck? I mean, what do you do? Like, what happens? I guess I missed that part when I watched the anime.
And this is where Rim ended up realizing what Light's full plan was. And that was to get suspicion back on Misa so that Rim would have to intervene and kill L to protect Misa. Because Rim deeply cared about Misa. So it was pretty much wraps from here. The power goes out and she didn't already kill Watari. This old man fighting for his life. So he ends up deleting all the data. And then a few seconds later, it happens. L has a heart attack falls over. Yep. And before he dies, the last thing that he sees is this evil, dick-headed ass smirk just to rub it in at the last second. And the lights went out.
Just to rub it in at the last second, bro. That shit was crazy, bro. When I first seen this, bro, I ain't gonna hold you. I love this anime. I wish they did more with that. Damn, because that, especially this part right here,
falls over. And before he dies, the last thing that he sees is this evil, dick-headed ass smirk just to rub it in at the last second.
And
the
just to rub it, because this whole time, it just, you know what, because I'm a rant for like 3 hours, yeah. If I even start, like,
now here comes the attitude swap up. Look at this fucker, he's like,
let me chill out.
No, it was the Shinigami guys.
No, y'all, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I really do hate this nigga.
He was acting for real. Admit,
game is game. This man is the best mass manipulator right beside this bastard.
Right, like what? Later,
he ends up finding Rim's pile of ashes because she died because she was saving Misa, and Light just casually takes his Death Note back. So after this, Light was about to go on another mass murder requiem. This man stands at the top of the building, pulls out his pen, and just started going on a rampage. These two people that were on the task force, that were basically convicts, yeah, it was raps for them. Bootleg Nina Williams, she's out here riding her motorcycle. She has a heart attack, crashes the motorcycle, and dies. In this next one,
in front of the black cat,
this dude right here, Iber, his wife and kid walks in the room, and the kid's like, "Daddy!" Just to see his dad's corpse fall on the ground.
Shit.
Oh man, and y'all remember the Yotsuba group? They thought they were scot-free. Renji gets up and tells Suguru that we did it, man. This is a new start for Yotsuba. Yeah, man, our stock is about to roar. Just for this man to fall over, cough up blood, and
die right there.
He was cooked. He has a heart attack, and every single member of the Yotsuba group died. But Light didn't stop there. Now, I have a theory, because they didn't confirm this, but I honest to God think that this is true. While he's on this killing montage, it shows all the past news reporters that have reported on this man. Now, you see this woman right here. Keep this. On this board where it shows a bunch of criminals being wiped out, she is on the bottom right, and her picture goes
out. Really?
So that tells me this nigga killed all of the news reporters that said some shit about him. I'm sick. Actually fucking sick. Nigga said fuck bad press. Y'all can.
Whoa! I didn't even realize that. You said you can't even name the eyes. Shinigami aren't supposed to tell you. You can't even see the name without the eyes. And Shinigami aren't supposed to tell you. No, I knew that, Galactic. You said that part. He was smiling at. Oh man, it was like, it was me this whole time, nigga. Right, exactly. Like, bro. Nah, but see, I'm confused on why you would take half of your lifespan away again. Like, what's the point if you already got the Shinigami eyes? Like, I'm confused.
TMZ.
Like, can somebody explain?
That said some shit about him. I'm sick. I'm actually fucking sick. Nigga said fuck bad press.
He said fuck all of them.
TMZ. And after this, it just got worse. Over the next 5
years. Why you say 5, Black?
Light's killings increased tenfold because there was nobody that could stop him. So this is a time where this man had to have dropped off at least 100,000 plus. Nigga, America claimed him as law, judge, jury, and executioner because they couldn't do nothing. Look at George Bush old ass. You know he ain't do shit. But I can't blame the old nigga because life's reign of terror just got worse and worse and worse. I mean, the nigga can control Truck Coon on command. And the most chilling thing this man
did
was go to L's grave and just start derangingly laughing his ass off. Look at this nigga. He has his ass up. He's twerking at his grave and
what?
On his shit.
I mean, look all right, at CJ, CJ.
This nigga lights
all right, CJ.
Eat my testicles, nigga.
And what the fuck?
Moving.
Wait, all right.
Hawk Tua. And with Light's victory,
We now move into our final set of evidence. Now, at this point in time, Light has taken the mantle of L.
Yes, that's crazy.
Light just didn't kill L. He took his whole flow, his whole name. And L's successors, Near and Mello, are now on his ass. So Mello in the Mafia decided to kidnap the director of the MPA so they could trade him for the Death Note. So guess what Light did? Ding, ding, ding. You probably guessed it. Light kills the director of the MPA so the Mafia will lose their leverage. Yep. But guess what? That's just the start of this last little list that I have. So you want to hear some more terrible
you
shit?
Rude.
I
got the you. Eyes
so
you
since
now.
Light killed the director.
Wait, for real? So then, really? And so, you just don't get your life. You don't get your lifespan back. And so when you got the death, when she got the Death Note back again, and then one of the Shinigami eyes again, that's just wow. I didn't know that. What? He was hacked. What so you mean? Not twerking on El Grave. I'm haunting you. Right, what the fuck?
Shit? I got
right.
You. So since Light killed the director of the MPA, Mello and the Mafia decided, let's kidnap this man's sister so they could get more leverage. So after this whole trade went down and they got back his sister, she was so traumatized by this experience. Her mind was broken. She was so fucked up, she couldn't even talk. Had her in a wheelchair and everything at Arkham Asylum. And his sister was sadly a victim of his actions. But guess who also was a victim of his actions? His daddy. Yeah, this man used his dad as a pawn. So to get back
I forgot about that. But hold on, y'all, I'm finna pause this recording because I gotta piss. The alcohol getting to me. All right, y'all, we back. Just had to piss real quick.
Light decided to relinquish dad as a pawn. So to get back that Death Note, Light decided to relinquish his and made Misa send a message that said, Kira will be relinquishing his Death Note to somebody in the task force. And guess who took ownership of that Death Note and made the Shinigami ideal? His daddy. So later, they end up raiding Mello's hideout. And at the end of the raid, Light tells his dad to confront Mello. So while Light's dad is confronting Mello, Light's dad was hesitant about writing his name down and killing him. So one of the dudes that was left alive shoots his dad in the back, and Mello blows up his hideout. So after this, they are in the hospital, and Light's dad is about to die. So you know what this sick, pathetic bastard does? He says, Dad, please, before you go, you've got to write his name down.
Is this nigga serious?
Come on, right. Motherfucker, help me out here, damn it. Do something useful for your son before you fucking die.
Oh my God. Get him the fuck out of here. Get him the, please. Black, get him the fuck.
This nigga Drewski,
bro. I'm here.
Like, I can't begin to tell you how pathetic this shit was. Yo, dad is about to die because of your actions, by the way. And you begging this nigga to get somebody's name for your personal gain. Sick bastard. And this wasn't even the worst part. Since his dad had the Shinigami eyes, he looked at Light and said,
Oh, sonny boy, I'm glad to see that you not Kira because I could see your lifespan. I could die at peace.
This man's dad died not knowing that his son was Kira because he relinquished that Death Note. Because the thing was that if you were a user of the Death Note, a person with Shinigami eyes could not see your lifespan. So his dad died living a lie. Sickening shit. And his blood is on Light's hands. So this man joins Doflamingo in the Patricide Club. Now we have come down to our last.
See, bruh. You said him not caring about his dad dying got me like, bro, fuck this dude. See, like, I feel like he did care a little bit, though. But just, you know. See, I feel like he cared a little bit, though. Don't, let's not act like he ain't give a fuck at all. But, you know, he was definitely being selfish. That's for sure. He was definitely being selfish. You said, to this day, I still don't know if Light was genuinely upset with what happened to his dad or that he just couldn't help him. Beat Mello and Deer. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know for sure, but like, I feel like he wasn't bullshitting. Then was like real tears and he was crying, but like, just, you know, he's just so manipulative.
Just
I guess he got over it quickly. I don't know how to explain manipulation. It.
So while Kira's influence was growing stronger in the world, and Light was out here inciting riots to stop Nier, he needed the right people to spread his message. So the ex-Kira, Teru Mikami, who was basically Light's right-hand man that he personally chose after making Misa relinquish her Death Note again and losing all of her memories, decided we need a change of management. So this fat nigga, Demigawa, who was the leader of Kira's kingdom and the spokesperson for this cult, decided to stream
the KKK or something, the fuck, on TV.
Tell me how you feel now.
Yes, Lord.
So Mikami said, fuck these niggas. So he deletes single one of these lunatics on live TV.
Delete.
Then he saved Demigawa's fat ass for last. He said, the doors of the church are open, but not for you.
But not for you.
So after Mikami disbanded the Church of Kira, he chose a loyal supporter of Kira to be the next spokesman.
Delete.
And that was Kiyomi Takada, Light's ex-girlfriend back in college. So you see where this is probably gonna go, right? So Light convinced the task force that we should use Shorty to get some more leverage on Kira and find out who that is. But obviously, Light had ulterior motives with her. So one night, he meets up with her. So here go this manipulation riz.
How you doing, Shorty? You looking as fine as ever.
And he just had her in the palm of his hand. So he basically told her, look, Shorty, I'm Kira.
And I see that my dog has chosen you as my spokesperson.
Sorry, my lip was, so I'ma make you look, my lip was itching, so I made that noise. Sorry, y'all. Just my lip was itching.
And he just had her in the palm of his hand. So he basically told her, look, Shorty, I'm Kira.
And I see that my dog has chosen you as my spokesperson. So I'ma make you the goddess of the new world.
And she was so ecstatic. She was entrenched in this nigga. And yeah, y'all could probably guess what happened after this. Now they don't show it, but let's be real. So after Light got done getting his freak on and getting talking to work with him, he had Shorty basically being another Kira. So he made Mikami make a fake notebook and sent the actual names to Takano, bringing her in and making her do some damn killing. And she was just...
Hold up, time out. 10 seconds.
Dignitized. So bringing her in and making her do some damn killing. And she was just dignitized. She had that Jeffrey Dahmer syndrome when Shorty's was just fiending over that nigga for some odd reason. But time for shit to get crazy. So one day, Takada ends up getting ran up on and kidnapped by Mello. So a couple hours passed and Mello started trying to interrogate her. Bro pulled out the gun and said, all right, chop chop.
Oh, this nigga.
Take them clothes and start shaking them booty cheeks. I'm gonna blow your fucking brains out, bitch. So while she starts stripping, she ends up taking a piece of the Death Note out that she had on her bra. So while Mello's transporting her in the back of his truck, she ends up calling Light and she on the phone saying, oh my God. Shake my booty cheeks. So Light said,
Now, did you do what I told you to do if you ever
you
got
a situation
like
this? You better not have shaken them booty cheeks.
Yeah. And that is what she did, because she wrote Mello's name down and killed that nigga. But Light, being a sick and twisted bastard, decided, nah, I'ma get as much out of you as I can until your gas tank is empty, bitch. So Light told her on the phone,
the time has come. Execute order 66.
So he made her call up Mikami and made her tell him, send me as many criminals as you can so I can go on a killing spree. So while she was doing that, Light was just sitting in the car on the way to go pick her up. And in his head, he just said,
man, you know what? You should have never went to that frat party without me, bitch.
And just ends up killing her. I forgot.
Light made her unalive herself by burning herself alive and setting everything on fire to get rid of every single piece of evidence.
And just like that, that was Light Yagami's final victim.
Because the next day on January 28th, this nigga got.
attack. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, with the final confrontation with Nier, Light got cooked. This nigga was so sad, bro. Nier read this motherfucker like a book. It was actually fucking hilarious seeing this nigga lose his mind. Because Mikami utterly failed, so Light tried to pull a fast one, but Matsuda just dumped bullets in his ass. So for Light to escape, Mikami just unlocked himself. Nigga committed seppuku, and Light just ran away. But they didn't even bother chasing him. He was done. So Ryuk, watching over the whole thing, was just like,
well, I give it to you, Light. You was one entertaining motherfucker. But I need my notebook back.
And on January 28th, 2010, anime's most deadliest serial killer dies of a heart attack. Man, how everything comes full fucking circle, doesn't it, buddy?
I remember when I first watched it, too, and finally had the ending, bro. I just felt kind of empty, bro. I ain't gonna hold you. Like, I was just like, because I know Light's not like a fucking, he's not a saint, obviously, but like, I was just like, dang, all that just to end like that. Like, I just felt empty, y'all. I ain't gonna hold you. I don't know how to explain it. Maybe it's a conversation for a different time, but still. You said that was fucked up, right? Said about to take a shot of the 99 bananas. You should, Galactic. Get on my level. Get on my level right quick. You feel me? Shit, you know what I mean? But, yeah, hey, you know. W video, we ain't done. Hold up.
Everybody, it's time for our final tally. Now, obviously, keeping kill count in this is literally impossible because there were mad off-screen deaths. And he just wasn't killing criminals. He was killing innocent people, too. And also people with just petty crimes. He probably killed your ass if you got a speeding ticket. Because this motherfucker was just evil. I mean, you know how many families he probably tore apart doing this shit? A lot. Shit,
right.
Like it was one prayer for these families, man. But here's what we'll do. If one of y'all can get an actual reasonable number and people actually agree with you, I'll pin the comment and we'll make that our number. But you know what that number gonna be right now? Drum roll, please.
A lot.
It is what it is.
Nigga said a lot. Oh,
anyways,
my God.
Man, case closed. And that is another installment of Anime's Deadliest Serial Killers. So, hope y'all enjoyed and get ready, baby. Because our next trial is going to be the beefiest one we've
Shredder?
Ever had. Yes, I'm already giving you a warning right now.
So, Shredder?
Until then, I'm out this, huh?
Yeah.
Shit. Hey, you know, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. You feel me? W video. Wait, hold up. Oops. W video, though. You feel me? I need y'all to share y'all's energy with me through the video so I can heal this arm faster. You feel me? Look at my arm. Give it to me. Give it. All right, I got the energy. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe. If you can't think of nothing to comment, just put a fire emote. And yeah, follow me on Twitch because we live right now. Follow me on Twitch, crunk_jeezy with two Y's. And yeah, that's it. All my socials is that too, crunk_jeezy. All my socials, my Instagram, Twitter, all that. But all right, cool.
It's a fact.
W reaction though, W video. Let me stop this recording right quick. Boom.